Okay, here we go. My name is Uli. Living in Singapore, coming to Thailand very often. I hope you have been attending my previous talk as well. So today I want to talk about the Hungry Bot. So in my previous session, you might have seen that we spoke about LINE messaging and cognitive services. I've done a few experiments in this field, and in essence, I was trying to find out if a bot looks at my Instagram feed, what would he think, right? So those who follow me on Instagram, they'll see I'm not just a geek. I'm also having a huge appreciation for design, logo work, for example, architecture, food, photography. And yeah, so in essence, what I've asked myself is, you know, we've spoken about cognitive services, computer vision, image recognition. What if I send 1,000 of these photos against a cognitive intelligence and distill the results? And since this is a 5 minutes talk, I'll show you the result first. So this is not something I built. This is something the machine built, looking at my Instagram feed. So yes, you can see I'm a foodie. Apparently I like streets, city, water, buildings, right? This is incredible. I mean, I think a couple of years ago, this would have been considered magic, right? How can a machine, where you only have 1,000 images, there is no EXIF data, there is no speaking file names, it's just image 1, image 2, image 3, image 4. And the machine looks at the photos, right? And you get this. It's pretty much like a reverse Google image search. You search for pizza, and Google will show you photos of pizza. This is the other way around. Here is a photo, tell me what you see. I use a very small Python word cloud library to actually use this. So in this case, I've used the Microsoft Computer Vision API. I'm sure the thing from Google, from IBM Watson, works just the same. And in essence, you can do this even in curl, right? Sending a request to the AI, send the photo, and get the tags. A few examples. So this is one of my photos. You get a text, a close-up of a pizza. You get tags, pizza, food, table, sitting, cheese, plate, pepperoni. And you get a confidence score, so from 0 to 1. So you see 92, pretty confident. And I'm still not sure how the machine does it, but yeah, it's pretty accurate. A cup of coffee, right? Similar. In this case, 85% confident. This is in Vietnam. A wooden table next to a window. Impressive. A sunset over an ocean, 80%, right? So you see where all these tags come from, right? I've done this 1,000 times. But to be sure, this one. A bunch of bananas. No. But in turn, you see, it's only 37% confident. So what I've basically done is I've set the threshold and say, you got to be at least 80% confident, and then you can take the scores into the word cloud, right? And this is again the result that you saw. I've done a few hacks like this, and if you remember this URL or if you see me later, there is all kinds of weird hacks that I put on GitHub, mostly with code as well, so you can try this yourself. Thank you.